Xandeum versus Solana, how do the two relate to each other? Is Xandeum a chain of its own separate from Solana? Or is it just an extension of Solana? Does it work with the Solana ecosystem? All of these questions will be answered in this little video. So, if you think of Xandeum, Xandeum is using the Solana code base and is adding a scalable storage layer, right? So the storage is not centrally controlled. It's not something where, you know, we have some sort of central repository or a Ceph cluster or something. It is fully controlled by the blockchain with all the security guarantees of the Solana blockchain. And we're adding that storage layer and we're offloading the storage from the validators to specialized storage provider nodes. We dub them P nodes. So the P nodes and the P nodes community, that's an important part of the Xandeum ecosystem. And with that, you know, right now, as we're building the software and we have our own DevNet, that's a community-driven DevNet. Thanks, everyone, for taking part in that. And that's a chain of its own, obviously, because we need to test our stuff there. We have new releases there all the time. There will be a testnet also. And then at some point, once everything's there, we will go into mainnet. And then we just have two options. We here at Xandeum, and if you haven't heard of Xandeum, link down in the description, xandeum.com. Read everything about us, read the light paper, the white paper, all our ambitions. Read how you can become a node operator and all these things. So once we go into mainnet and our software has a state where we can test it in some mainnet alpha environment or something, we have two options. We could make it a chain of its own as we have it right now. It's our own blockchain. We call it the DevNet, the Xandeum DevNet. But it's our own chain. We have our own genesis and our own nodes, and they communicate with each other. So once we go into mainnet, we have two options, right? We can either take our validator software with that extension. We're a Solana extension, right? We're building that additional functionality into the Solana client, the so-called validator code. It's called a client. And we could just stay a chain of its own as we're doing right now, or we could approach the existing Solana validator community, and we're a Solana validator, an established one with, you know, over 400,000 SOL in stake. I mean, 400,000 SOL, that's 4 million SOL times 7, right? That's, you know, 28 million US dollars, right? So that's a lot of money that our customers trust us with for staking their SOL. If you haven't staked your SOL with us yet, link is in the description, zanstake.com, and you can stake your SOL there, and we're one of the best performing Solana validators there. So we're part of that ecosystem, and we have the option to just run our clients on the Solana mainnet with a modified version of the validator. And that's what Jito is doing these days. And we have the option to do that ourselves. Obviously, we'd have to approach the existing like 2,200 Solana validators. I think, you know, there will be a lot of them there that can then earn extra income by processing those storage transactions and monitoring the storage provider nodes, making sure they do what they are supposed to do. And then each Solana validator can earn extra income from that. So I think that is very well possible. Of course, we'd have to try once our software is there. We also have the option to just stay our own chain. But I think, you know, the synergy with the Solana ecosystem is so great, right? And we've seen that recently with the launch of the JTO token, the Jito token. And we've seen that fantastic airdrop that happened. And, you know, we might at some point do a similar airdrop for you guys if you adopt our technology early. If you want to know more, go to xandeum.com, learn everything about it, join our Discord. in the top right corner of the Xandeum website, there is a little Discord icon, so you can join our Discord server where you can chat live with the team, with myself, with all the other Xandeum guys, and you can engage live with us. So that's the relationship between Xandeum and Solana. We feel and always felt part of the Solana ecosystem. I've always, in all of my videos, talked great about Solana and everything. And we still have two options once mainnet is there. And most likely, if we can, at least from today's perspective, we will aim to be part of the Solana mainnet and just, you know, join forces with them rather than build another cluster that's our own blockchain and start so many things from scratch that are already there in Solana, right? So I love not reinventing the wheel. We at Xandeum, we are solving one problem, adding that scalable storage layer so that Web3, the real Web3, can become a reality, and that, you know, entrepreneurs can build Web3 apps with the same flexibility that the Web2, the current web, offers them, right? And to solve that, I just want to do only the missing part that's not there today, and that's the scalable storage layer, and otherwise harness everything that's already there. And that's not only the Solana code base, but it's also the whole Solana ecosystem. It's the Sol coin and all these type of things. All right. So if you like content like this, please give me that like button. It is really important for the YouTube algorithm. Subscribe to my channel and leave me comments there. No matter what it is, whether you like it, don't like it, have any questions, or, you know, just any other comments, just leave them there. For today, though, thanks so much for watching. Peace, and catch you later. Bye.